Hi, I'm Scott Sheldon, and welcome to this episode of Winegazer. Thank you so much for tuning in. So in this episode, if you haven't guessed, we're going to be doing a little food and wine pairing and cooking live right here in the kitchen. So, you know, it's the end of October, almost. Season's starting to change. Daylight savings is coming up in a few weeks. You know, starting to get cooler here in California, and it's the perfect time to start busting out those favorite fall recipes. So I'm gonna do a lamb stew for you guys today. Got the recipe from a Jamie Oliver cookbook, just kind of loosely throwing it around. And I'm gonna pair it up with a Montebuena Rioja, coming from Spain, 100% Tempranillo. Robert Parker gave this wine 90 points, comes in at $10.99 US. So, you know, I'm excited to try that. So I've got a hot pan here, medium heat. Let's get some olive oil going. All right. Got some nice diced onion, get that going. Chopped carrots. Celery, beautiful rosemary, fresh out of the garden or the balcony pot on the patio, if you will. Some potatoes. See if I can find a spoon here. Okay, so, you know, this is a really easy dish. One pot, you just throw a bunch of stuff in there, and you basically just braise it, keep cooking it till, you know, it falls apart, the meat falls apart, and it gets really reduced, and has a beautiful flavor to it, really concentrated. So, you just want to sweat out these vegetables. I'm not trying to brown them. Just keep cooking them medium heat for about 10 minutes, and we'll check back in, we'll add the meat to this, and then it'll really start getting interesting. See you in a minute. Okay, so you can see we've got all the vegetables here sweating away. We got our potatoes, the carrots, the celery, the onion, the rosemary, just sweating it out, getting that moisture out of there, just getting a nice flavor base for our stew. Get a nice look there. And we'll check back in a few minutes, add the lamb, and really get it going. Okay, so welcome back. We have our vegetables simmering away here, sweating down for 10 minutes. Now it's time to start adding some more ingredients. New Zealand grass-fed leg of lamb chopped up for a nice stew. That's what I'm talking about right here. Tell me that doesn't look beautiful, unless you're a vegetarian maybe. Get this meat in here. Two cups. Red wine. I'm going to use the same wine here that I'm going to be drinking with it. Don't worry, I got a second bottle. And 2 cups. Pour that in. Got 1 can here, 14 ounce diced tomatoes. Add that. 2 tablespoons all-purpose flour. Sprinkle that in, help thicken it up. Okay, I'm gonna start with just a little bit of salt and pepper and come back and you know, adjust it more later. Okay. So what we want to do here is just stir everything around, get it all together and happy. Then what we're going to do is cover this, bring it to a boil, cook it for 1.5 hours, take the lid off, and then cook it for another hour. 2.5 hours total cooking time. So I'm going to let this do its thing, and we'll check back in a little bit, and I'll show you where we're at. Okay, so you can see everything simmering together happily. You got our lamb thrown in there, some red wine, chopped tomatoes added, a little spice, a little bit of flour. And like I said, it's a long process, but it's easy. From this point on,
I don't have to really do too much, but just wait. Hour and a half, lid closed. One more hour after that, lid open. So I'm just gonna let this cook. Keep cooking down. We'll check back on it later.
Hey, welcome back. So stew is all finished. I'm gonna have a little taste of the wine and then taste both of them together and see how everything pairs up. So first with the wine, Montebuena 2009 Rioja. Again, 100% Tempranillo grapes, $10.99 US retail, and Robert Parker, 90 points. So let's check this out. So nice, deep, dark ruby color. Really, really dark. Let's give this a smell. A lot of leather coming through, some tobacco leaves. Little spice box, really ripe blackberry aromas coming through as well. Really great concentration of fruit on this wine. Great balance, good acid, a nice mouthfeel, a little bit of silk there, a little bit of weight. Again, you know, this is not an expensive wine, but it has a luxurious mouthfeel. And this is a little, you know, insight on the wines of Spain and Rioja. You know, there's definitely some values to be found in that area, under $20, under $15 even, as you can see with this wine. I'd have to agree with Parker, 90 points. I think that sounds good to me. Considering the price, considering the fruit, the mouthfeel, some of these other nerdy components, I really like it. I want to give it another taste. Again, 100% Tempranillo grapes. Let's try the stew. Here's the finished product. Hopefully you can see that. So everything's cooked down really nicely. It's more of a brown color as opposed to the pinkish color you saw earlier. Now the vegetables, the potatoes, everything's cooked down nicely. The meat just, I mean, falls apart. You don't even need a knife. Let's give it a little taste. Perfect for the fall in lamb stew, I tell you. It's a great combination. If you're gonna cook with lamb, Rioja is one of the best wines that you can pair with it. Cabernet Sauvignon does well, Pinot Noir, Syrah even. I really love Rioja when it comes to lamb. And so it's really interesting too, you know, when you cook with the wine that you're drinking, it all kind of transcends and comes through. And it's kind of like a no-brainer. You know that there's going to be something that's going to connect on some level because you have the wine that you're drinking is actually in the food that you're eating, which is it's really cool. So I think that's it for this episode. I hope you enjoyed a little wine pairing and cooking in the kitchen, and I want to do some more of this stuff for you. And keep commenting. I love when you comment down below, getting in those conversations. It's always fun. So until next time, cheers.